Okay. So you're going to have the kittens covered. If there's one or two, it doesn't matter. You know, they may both go in here. If you get one in here and the other is being resistant, that's fine too. Just shut it down and transfer it to another carrier, the second kitten. So kittens covered, you're in your car because if anything goes wrong, you don't want an escapee. You have the carrier open. This serves as one side. You get a box. You can use the side, you know, like your door, your car door. You can use anything to block this second side. You want something kind of bigger like that, maybe, just so that it can't come up the other side. So you have a trap perhaps that is this slanted, and you're gonna open that. This one's a little bit different as you have to kind of raise these rings and then raise the door. So you want to make sure that nothing can slide. With kittens, you're not going to have as much of a problem because they can't like run so fast that they're going to ram into this and slide it, and then you have a mess. If you can, try and get the door like this, so as you're opening it, you can slide the door in. But the tricky part, and it's always a tricky part, you want to get the door up enough so it comes above the hood of the carrier. Now, you see this little space. You're probably going to be kneeling on this side, so you want to use your leg, another box, whatever. If you can, if the kittens are in the back, and again, they're covered, so they're probably going to be in the back. If you can manage it, try and slide it right in here, so that there's just less room for error. And you have this on top, slide it right up. Okay. This is an optimal situation. If you can't, just do it from, you know, from a distance. So you have this, right? It's all set up, everything's propped and guarded. You're going to then lift up this. You know, start from the back, you know, lift it, slide it up. They may still be cowering because, again, their instinct is to stay away from you. You know, you're here. They don't want to come at you. So if you can, lean this way, you know, and kind of guide them. I find that it really stubborn ones, if you blow on them, they don't like that. So they will then come forward and get into the carrier. So, you know, you can lean in, blow on them, they come up, again, optimally speaking, and then you can just shut this like so, okay? And then just, you know, keep your hands, and again, it sounds like these aren't really terribly feral kittens. You can keep your hand here, slide it out again, keep it there, and then you're gonna lock it, and you're good to go. You know, you wanna do it in your car. Just so that if something goes wrong, it's in the car, and the cat cannot escape the car if it is out in the car, even if it gets up under the wheel, the steering column, which happened with Alex's car. Poor thing, her virgin voyage with trapping in her new car, and I managed to get a cat stuck in the car. So took me 4 days, but I was able to retrap it. So that is kind of the long and the short demonstration of how to do a transfer. You know, again, bring even a piece of cardboard, one of the fork, you know, looks like a fork divider, kind of prop it up. You know, it's a little bit tricky, but you know, it can be done, especially if you only have two traps. So again, you know, you're going to have this all prepped. You're going to open this up, lift this, and again, if they're raring to go, that's okay. But let's say they get in here, and then you're like, crap, now what do I do? Because you can't shut the door, all right? You know, then just, you're going to have to kind of take that risk, you know, and slide that out as much as you can. So, all right, Marilyn, you can do it. That's it.